Welcome to Training Day 7. The Bengals cut Brandon LaFell today, which is big news, but also raises questions about the rest of the roster and how the young receivers are going to respond without their mentor around. Meanwhile, questions remain concerning the backup quarterback situation, the shifting of the offensive line, and who among the younger defensive ends is going to emerge. For all of those and more, we're going to go to John Sheeran live at Bengals training camp. John?
Hey guys, it's John here reporting just outside the gates of the practice fields outside of Paul Brown Stadium. I'm outside the gates because one of the security guards essentially told me, you don't have to go home, but you cannot stay here. I stayed, overstayed my welcome, and now I'm here instead of on the field. So, with that said, some updates from August 2nd's practice of Bengals training camp. Brandon LaFell got cut a few hours before practice, which meant that it was John Ross and Tyler Boyd officially cemented as team second and third receivers on offense. It should be noted that the base offense of this team is 11 personnel, so there's three wide receivers on the field. And when they are in those sets, it's Ross on the outside, Boyd in the slot. When the team has two wide receivers, it's sometimes Boyd, it was sometimes Ross. So that needs to be established, I think. It's not a matter of who's on outside, who's on inside. Both guys are going to get their equal fair share of play, and that's kind of what we saw in practice. Boyd had another really good day today. He was featured in their two-minute offense. He had a couple of good catches over the middle, and he had a couple good catches in red zone contested-wise. So he had another good day. He's continuing his great camp. I think it's because of days like this. This is why they were so confident in letting go of Brandon LaFell even before they even played a preseason game. So that was good to see. Ross had a couple drops, but he actually did catch a Tyler Boyd drop over the middle. So figures he catches the hardest one, I guess. On the defensive side of the ball, Sam Hubbard actually stood out to me the most on the defensive line. He beat any tackle that came up against him, whether it be Cordy Glenn or Cedric Oboihe or even Jake Fisher. He had a stretch of plays where he had, you know, three or four consecutive hurries in a row, and I think he looks like a refined pass rusher even at just 22 years old. He has the athleticism to bend around the edge, but, you know, to see that handwork at such a young age, it's really impressive, and that's kind of the reason why Jordan Willis, on the other hand, has not been really flashing so far in training camp. It's because he's having a hard time with his process as a pass rusher, and I think it's going to be interesting to see if Hubbard eventually starts slowly overtaking Willis as that backup defensive end on the strong side, because if he offers more upside as a pass rusher, he'll find his way onto the field more times. Offensive line update, it was Trey Hopkins and Cedric Oboihe as first-team right guard and tackle, with Alex Redman and Jake Fisher rotating behind them. They also, Redman and Fisher also got reps with the first team, but it was Hopkins and Oboihe who were out there first. And backup quarterbacks had a kind of rough day. You saw a lot of overthrows from both Matt Barkley and Jeff Driscoll. I'm not sure that one has essentially established themselves as a favorite to be the backup behind Dalton, but as of now, it looks as bad as advertised, and that's kind of sucks because Logan Woodside still hasn't been featured in training camp. He's still in shorts, just kind of work with the team. Injury updates, Auden Tate, Josh Malone were seen on the sideline, standing around, just talking with other players. So hopefully their injuries are not too concerned. We're worried about a hamstring with Malone and a concussion with Tate. And Tyler Eifert was on the rehab field, just working out. It wasn't in like a jersey or pads up top, but was on the field for some little offensive-only route running drills, so that was good to see. I think they're just easing him slowly back. But that about does it for here Thursday, August 2nd, outside of Bengals training camp, and I'll be back here tomorrow as well.
Thank you for that report, John. It was tremendous. And I apologize about the security issue. But, you know, either you didn't wear the press outfit I ordered for you, or maybe it was too small, or maybe it just wasn't convincing enough. I don't know, but we will figure it out next time. Make sure to tune back in for training day 8. So long, sweet boys.